Rocky Graziano.
The International Boxing Club has finally put together the match that the American public has been seeing through its crystal ball for many years. A so-called dream match between the challenger and former middleweight champion of the world, Rocky Graziano, and the current middleweight champion of the world, Sugar Ray Robinson. They're giving a demonstration of his magically fast feet in his traditional pre-fight round. Round one. Graziano, the shorter of the two, has the shorter reach and has come in at 160 pounds flat, while Sugar Ray Robinson has come in at 158. Graziano's task will be getting under those long arms of Ray Robinson. His power lies in his strong right arm, his ability to force a fight and mix it at great length. In Ray Robinson, Graziano, who has never been regarded as a boxer, meets one of the greatest master boxers of all time, called by many, pound for pound, the greatest fighter of our time. Robinson shows plenty of authority in his own right arm. And there you see a beautiful example of his combination punching. Graziano being warned by the referee not to rabbit punch. Graziano is 29 years old, and Ray Robinson is 32. Both of these men have known what it is to lose their middleweight championships of the world. In order to get in past the reach of Ray Robinson, Graziano had to dash forward in a maneuver typical of Jake LaMotta when he has been fighting bigger men. The first time that Graziano has thrown a vaunted right hand, and his right hand again drives Robinson back. Robbie was stung by that right hand. Graziano continues to force the fight, set the pace throughout. A beautiful exchange. Robinson's theory apparently is to box Graziano and stay away from his right hand. Round two. Graziano first loomed on the boxing horizon in 1945 with his sensational KO of the Philadelphian Billy Arnold. At that time, he shrieked, "Get me Ray Robinson," who even in 1945 was an established boxing star. Graziano was to wait 7 years, but here he is. On the moment he himself called for. Graziano has beaten such stars as Charlie Fuseri, Tony Gennaro. His finest hour came in 1947, when he won the middleweight championship of the world from Tony Zale in his second fight with Zale. Robinson looked very good in his training for this fight and as fast as ever, although believed by some to be on a downhill slide. Robinson remains respectful of Graziano. Robbie himself is not a one-hand punch knockout artist, but depends upon his marksmanship and a steady tattoo on one particular spot to wear his man down. There you see those flashing fists and that beautiful timing. But again, Robinson has to back up before Graziano. Notice how in coming out of a clinch, Robinson will start throwing punches first, gaining that split half second. Keep his man off balance. And to get in the blows, that will eventually win for him. Graziano appears to be tired. That blow came as the bell sounded. Round three. Robinson won his title in February 14, 1951 from Jake LaMotta, lost it to Randy Turpin in England in July, and regained it in a tremendous effort in September in New York City. There you see him double hooking and carrying those punches underneath into the body. At this point, many experts are saying that Graziano looked anything but bad in his boxing against Ray Robinson. And Ray goes down. It's an official knockdown. But before the fight began, the Illinois Boxing Commission ruled that a man would not have to stay down for the mandatory count of eight. Maybe the knockdown will infuriate Robinson. This has been his history and his great efforts in the ring. It took a lashing by Randy Turpin in their second fight to bring him back to a point where he smashed Turpin to the ground to take back the middleweight championship of the world. So Graziano has scored the first knockdown. And there goes his mouthpiece, and Graziano hits the canvas. Two, three, four, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. Ray Robinson retains the middleweight championship of the world. Graziano is still trying to kick some life into his legs and some spark into his numbing senses. A crowd of 23,785, which never sat in its expensive seats, witnessing one of the finest exchanges for the middleweight championship of the world, paying over $252,000. Graziano walking dejectedly to his corner and understandably sad. This was the moment he had asked for, but certainly not the conclusion he had anticipated. But in his sadness, he might reflect that he was beaten by a man who has lost only twice in 136 fights in a brilliant career, called by many over and over again the finest fighting machine of our time, pound for pound, Sugar Ray Robinson, middleweight champion of the world.